Good morning. Let us see today what are ladder operators. What are ladder operators? They are new set of operators called step up operator, step down operator. Step up and step down operators. The step up and step down operators are also called ladder operators. Okay, how they are constructed? How they are constructed? Ladder operators are actually used for orbital angular momentum operators. Ladder operators are used for angular momentum operators. There are two types of orbital, there are two types of rotational motion. Okay, there are for electron, there are two types of angular motion. They are orbital angular motion and spin angular motion. Spin angular momentum, and there are two types of angular momentum. Orbital angular momentum, it is represented by L, and spin angular momentum, it is represented by S, and J equal to the total angular momentum. Total or total angular momentum, quantum number, J equal to L plus S. Okay, the ladder operators for angular momentum operators are constructed from the components of are constructed from the Lx and Ly components of angular momentum. Angular momentum operators. For example, L cap plus equal to L cap x plus I Ly. L cap y. And L cap minus equal to L cap x minus I L cap y. This is known as step up operator, angular momentum ladder operator, and step down. This is known as step down operator. And similarly, S plus for spin angular momentum. For spin angular momentum operator, the step up operator is S plus cap equal to Sx cap plus I Sy. Similarly, you can construct for total. Similarly, for total angular momentum operator, the step up and step down operators are constructed as below. Jx cap plus I, similarly we can construct. Okay, now they have the effect of then these operators have the effect of rising the eigenvalues or lowering the eigenvalues. They rise the they increase the eigenvalue by one atomic unit, or they lower the, they decreases the eigenvalue by one atomic unit. We will see. Okay, now commutation rule, similar to we have studied earlier angular momentum operators. Angular momentum operators, please see the angular momentum lesson and understand. The same rules are applied here. The same commutation rules are applied here. For example, j cap square and j plus step up operator commute with each other. They constitute commutator. They form commutator operator. Whereas j cap z and j cap z, they do not commute with each other. Okay, so then j cap plus j cap z equal to minus h cross j cap plus. Okay, similarly j cap minus comma j cap z, they do not commute with each other. Therefore gives, we can derive this, the expression we can derive this in as you can derive in your notebook very easily. Okay, so next we will see the angular wave function. The angular wave function for orbital motion, for total angular momentum, angular motion, j psi is the angular wave function, which is a function of the j and the m. Okay, in Dirac notation, the wave function, the angular wave function, is represented in Dirac notation. It is nothing but wave function. Don't confuse. Don't afraid of this. This is nothing but bracket notation, Dirac notation. This is nothing but wave function. Okay, this is the wave function for orbital angular motion, to describe the orbital angular motion, which is a function of two quantum numbers. They are called spherical harmonics, L comma m, L and comma m. Similarly, this is the wave function to describe the to describe the spin angular motion. Spin angular motion psi, s psi, which depends on s and ms, that is represented by s modulus s comma ms bracket. Okay. So now we have already studied the eigenvalue equation. Nothing you need not afraid of this. This is nothing but eigenvalue equation. This is nothing but your eigenvalue equation. J cap square operates on your function, gives eigenvalue and eigenfunction and its wave function. Okay. This is nothing but A cap psi equal to A psi, small A psi. So J cap square operates on the wave function. Okay, angular wave function, total angular wave function gives kj and km, and similarly j cap is operates on a wave function, okay, angular wave function, and gives km, the wave function, kj and km are the eigenvalues. What are the kj and km? Kj and km are the eigenvalues. Okay, now kj and km, what are kj and km? For example, here I have given j cap square operates on j cap square, that is the square of angular momentum operator, operates on the wave function, okay, gives the eigenvalue j into j plus 1 across the wave function. Remember, this is the eigenvalue, so kj, this is kj. This is kj equal to, similarly, l cap square equal to l comma m, therefore l into small l into l small l plus 1 x cap square. J cap, similarly j cap is a operates on the function, gives mj. Mj is the ml h cross. For example, l equal to 2 or j equal to 2, ml equal to minus 2, minus 1, 0, plus 1, plus 2. Okay, so these are the mj values, mj or ml values. Similarly, ms I have given here. Okay, now let us see the effect of j plus. So we have obtained that kj and km eigenvalues here. We have obtained that kj and km eigenvalues. They are nothing but, these are nothing but eigenvalue equations you have studied in your past minutes. Now let us study effect of step up and step down operator on the eigenvalues. Okay. So let us operate j cap square and the effect of operator j cap plus. Okay, same this thing, j cap square and j cap operates on the step up operator, operates on the wave function. Therefore, kj, same value, kj, j plus cap, the wave function. Okay, similarly, j minus kj. So, there is no effect when the step up, remember, when the step up and step down operator operates on j cap square, j cap square, the function, the wave function, there is no change, there is no change, no increase or decrease in the eigenvalue. But this is very, very important. Okay, whereas when j cap operates on, when j cap operates on, j cap is a, the wave function gives km plus, remember, you see, km plus h cross, one h cross. Okay, so the eigen, and then you will get j cap plus j, the wave function, the Dirac wave function. Therefore, the wave function km plus h cross, one h cross, the eigenvalue increases or rises by one atomic unit due to step up operator. When step up operator operates on the wave function along j z cap, the eigenvalue increases or rises by one atomic unit. Okay, so we step in go, step up in ladder, one step up in ladder. Okay, similarly, what is the effect of step down operator on j z cap and wave function? You see km minus h cross. Therefore, the eigenvalue decreases by one unit When step down operator operates on the Dirac wave function, on the wave function along the j z direction. Okay, I have told, for example, l equal to 2, ml equal to minus 2, minus 1, 0, plus 1, plus 2. I have shown reverse. So similarly, J, total quantum number, angular momentum, therefore J equal to mj equal to, and similarly, these the angular momentum values are quantized. The angular momentum values are quantized and split. Okay, so you have 5, 1, 2, 3, 5 quantized angular momentum values, and m, this is j term z, jm, mj, mj, j is minus 2, minus 2 h cross, okay, minus 2 plus h cross, and mj minus 1, therefore this is mj value, and this is mj value, therefore minus h cross and 0, h cross and 2, h cross, km. These are km eigenvalues. So, they can be represented in the ladder form. And when the step up operator operates on this wave function, then the value rises by 1 unit. Similarly, or it decreases by 1 unit. Step 1, step up in a ladder, okay, it is similar to step up in ladder or step down in a ladder by 1 unit, by 1 step only. Okay, similarly, this is for, this is the wave function for spin angular motion, S and MS. This is represented by alpha, and this is represented by beta, alpha spin, beta spin, that is, in Dirac rotation, 1 by 2, and the MS can be plus or minus of, therefore 1 by 2. There are two quantized angular momentum, spin angular momentum values. They are split as shown in the figure along the z axis. Okay, so similarly, it will go from minus alpha beta to alpha, alpha to beta due to the effect of step up and step down operators. Okay, so please understand first the angular momentum operator. You first to see the video lesson and understand. Thank you for watching.